السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. We start the new chapter. Chapter Bab Adab Iyadat al-Mariyah. The manners of visiting the sick. The manners of visiting the sick. Okay? He mentioned Hadith Bara' ibn Azib. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered us with 7 commands and forbade us from 7 prohibited matters. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered us to follow funerals by praying the funeral prayer and then following the corpse until the burial is completed. Number 2, to visit the sick. طيب. So this is the point, to visit the sick. So this is one of the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or one of the commands. I like here to mention a point, maybe many of us don't realize this point. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said here, al-marid. Al-marid. Okay, what does it mean with marid? Sick person, صح? The sick. Okay, so visiting the sick. So this word, al-marid, includes even the unconscious person. The unconscious person. Okay, because many times, okay, people ask, there is a sick. Yeah, for example, your father is sick, or your grandfather is sick. Okay. How is your father? Wallahi, alhamdulillah, he's sick. Is he conscious or unconscious, yani? Wallahi, he's unconscious. Or he's Alzheimer, he doesn't know people. Subhanallah, wallahi, I'm thinking to visit him, but he's Alzheimer. Habibi, please, brothers, sisters, go and visit him. He's conscious, he's unconscious, he's Alzheimer, dementia. He knows you or he doesn't know you. Okay, please go and visit him because he is sick. The Prophet ﷺ did not say, visit only the conscious sick people. If he is marid, then it is your duty to visit him. Okay? So please, brothers, sisters, go and visit the sick. Conscious, unconscious, he knows you or he doesn't know you, he speaks or he doesn't speak. Go and visit him. This is one of the sunnah or one of the commands of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the second thing, also, the Prophet ﷺ visited some of the companions and they were unconscious. So please, brothers, sisters, many Muslims don't know this point, okay? Or they don't realize this point, that if the sick is unconscious, we don't visit him. He's unconscious in the hospital for 10 months. Go and visit him. Go visit him. You get ajr from Allah. You make dua for him. His family will be happy. Yani imagine, subhanAllah, your father or your mother in the hospital or at home. Khalas, yani they have Alzheimer. They don't know anyone. And also they are not speaking. Okay, and imagine your father at home for 10 months. None of his friends visit him. SubhanAllah. Why they are not visiting your father? Because he doesn't know. You will feel sad and bad. You feel bad. But imagine every day or every 2 days, one of his friends visits him. You feel happy. His friend, wallahi, visiting my father, making dua for him, talking about him, talking with him. Feel happy. So in this chapter, we are talking about the sick. Conscious or unconscious? طيب. So this is one of the commands from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I will not mention the hadith because there are many issues. It will take a long time to explain all of them. طيب. Number one, فضل عيادة المريض. The manners, the virtues of visiting the sick. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من عاد مريضا لم يزل في خرفة الجنة حتى يرجع. The Prophet ﷺ said, whoever visits a sick person, continues to remain in khurfat of paradise. Khurfat of paradise are the fruits when the fruits one picks from the date trees of paradise. Khurfa, yani, if you have a garden and you have trees and there are fruits, okay. Yakhrif, yani, you are taken from the fruits. You are taken from the fruits. The fruits are ready to eat. So are taking the fruits. Okay? So if you visit, you are taken from the fruits of the paradise until you come back. So imagine how long you are spending, maybe 20 minutes driving to the hospital. Then you are sitting there for 20 minutes. Then you are coming back 20 minutes. So during this 1 hour, you are getting fruits from the paradise. لم يزل في خرفة الجنة. Another hadith. Jabir ibn Abdullah رضي الله عنه reported that he heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, whoever visits a sick person waits in الرحمة, the mercy, until he sits down. When he is firmly entrenched in it and mercy. Okay, so you'll be in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are merged in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is number two. Number one, you get the fruits from the paradise. Number two, you'll get the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he mentioned a hadith. Hadith al-Qudsi. Or hadith Rabbani. Allah says in the hadith, Ya ibn Adam, maridtu falam ta'udni. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, O son of Adam, I became sick, yet you did not visit me. Then he will say, Ya Rab, kayfa a'uduka wa anta rabbul alameen. Oh my Lord, how can I visit you and you are the Lord of all that exists? You are the Lord, you are the one who cures, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet, the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, أَمَا عَلِمْتَ أَنَّ عَبْدِي فُلَانًا مَرِضًا فَلَمْ تَعُدْ. He will say, subhanahu wa ta'ala, did you not know that such and such slave of mine became sick, but you did not visit him? Did you not know that had you visited him, you would have found me with him? Subhanallah. This hadith Sahih Muslim. So when you visit, you'll find the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will give you the ajr by visiting the sick. This is Islam. When they talk about Islam, they will not mention like these points. They will cut some of the ayat of jihad. طيب اقتلوهم حيث تقفتموهم. Kill them whenever you see them, wherever you see them. They take part of the ayah and they don't explain the ayah. Then they say, this is Islam. The religion of killing, the religion of blood. They don't mention like this hadith. Like this hadith. We should visit the sick people. If you notice the hadith, the beginning of the hadith, طيب, or not in this hadith, another hadith, حق المسلم على المسلم, the right of the Muslim over another Muslim. طيب, but also you can visit the non-Muslim. You can visit the famous hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم visit the Jews, the boy. So it means it is allowed to visit the non-Muslim. We make dua for the non-Muslim, you can make dua. You can make dua, but not you ask the mercy for him or the forgiveness. You can ask the shifa for him. You can ask the cure. Allahumma shfihi. Yes, you can. Maybe your father is sick and your father is not Muslim. Can I make dua for him? Yes. Allahumma shfihi wa afi. Allah give him the cure. Health, yes. But not the mercy, not the forgiveness. So also, you can visit the non-Muslims. You can visit the non-Muslims. Also, a great hadith as a virtue of the visiting with the sick. Whoever goes to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever goes to the visit his sick Muslim brother is walking the khurfat al jannah. We mentioned this point. Then when he sits down, if it is the morning that he visits him, then 70,000 angels pray over him until the night arrives. And if it is in the night, then 70,000 angels pray over him until the morning arrives. 70,000 angels make dua for you, morning and evening. Because of what? Because visiting the sick. Subhanallah. Ajeeb wallahi. Yani Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes to forgive our sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves his slaves. والله يريد أن يتوب عليكم. Allah says in the Quran, والله يريد أن يتوب عليكم. يعني it means Allah wants, here means Allah likes to make tawbah for you. يعني do anything. Do anything just to have a reason to get the tawbah and the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب الله والله يريد أن يتوب عليكم. So this is a great reward that 70,000 angels make dua for you morning and evening. Number two, visiting sick children. Sick children. Usama ibn Zayd said, a daughter of the Prophet ﷺ sent a message to him. Meanwhile, he, Usama, Sa'd, and Ubay were with the Prophet ﷺ. This was the messenger. He think that my daughter is in the final stages of dying. It means the granddaughter of Rasulullah ﷺ. So come to us. The daughter of Rasulullah ﷺ, maybe Zainab, send a message to the Prophet ﷺ, or Rasulullah, or dad, come to me. Because my daughter is dying. طيب. She did not die, she is dying. So she is sick. Means. The Prophet ﷺ sent greetings of peace to her, saying, verily to Allah belongs what he takes and what he gives, and everything is decreed with him for an appointed time. So seek your reward from him and be patient. She then sent another message, taking an oath upon him that he should go to her. Okay, so please, brothers and sisters, I like here to notice that subhanallah, his daughter in a big yani, it is a calamity or it is a trial that she's losing her daughter. The Prophet ﷺ did not come at the beginning. Then she insisted and he came. Okay, so there is a point that when there is janazah, should I come and attend this, the azah, the condolences after the janazah? You know, now as a habit, here in Kuwait, we sit at home 3 days, صح? Do you have this habit there or 3 days? More? Okay. I mean, so we have the same habit, huh? That the family of the decent stay, men alone, women alone, and people come for condolences, صح? طيب. 3 days, this is not sunnah from the Prophet ﷺ. It's not sunnah. Okay, the point is, can we do this or not? Some scholars say this is makruh. Some scholars say this is makruh. To sit at home, to stay at home, and we open the door and people come for us. Some scholars say this is makruh, khalas. After the janazah, yes, in the janazah, you pray, make dua for the janazah, khalas, that's it. Then if you meet يعني if your friends meet you, yes, they can give you the condolences. They can do تعزية. طيب, but to stay at home and people come, they say this is not sunnah, makruh. Some scholars say this is okay. Okay. Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah is one of the scholars who said this is bid'ah to tell people I will be at home for 3 days, okay, or more or less, and you can't come to me morning or evening. He said this is bid'ah. Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen very strict in this point. Okay, and one of the proofs, he mentioned this hadith. He said, look, his daughter told him, please dad, come. He did not come at the beginning. So don't force people and don't blame people that come to my home and support me. Okay, because I'm sad, I lost my father, I lost my mother, my son, my daughter. Okay, yani sometimes people blame you. I lost my father and you did not come to my aza. صح? Okay. Some families very strict. You have to come. And some of them ask you have to come 3 days. You have to sit with me. 3 days. Habibi, I have job. Okay, I cannot miss 3 days. Yani. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. And you want me to stay with you morning and evening? Yeah, difficult. 4 hours morning, 4 hours evening. Yani. More than my job. My job 6 hours and you want me 8 hours? Yani, this is not sunnah. This is not sunnah. Okay, if I meet you in the masjid, I say salam, or I call you, I send you a message. Alhamdulillah, this is enough. This is enough. So please, don't blame people. Okay, if you want to take the opinion that it's okay, it is allowed to sit at home and you receive people 3 days, okay, take this position. But please don't force people and don't blame people. Why you do not come to my house? I lost my father. You don't come to me. You don't call me. Don't blame them. Okay? Yeah, alhamdulillah. For sure, people, many people came to you. And forget the people who do not come. خلاص. طيب. So at this point, they mentioned this is the proof that if the young people, 2 years old, 3 years old, you visit them, this is sunnah, yes, this is sunnah. This is sunnah. Stop here, inshallah. Jazakum Allah khair. Salli wa sallam ala Muhammad. Yes, I like to mention a point. One of the brothers mentioned a point that last Saturday that for our videos, not only for my videos, for any of the da'iyah, for any of the sheikh, if you like the video, put like. If you have a comment, put your comment. Don't keep it empty for the brothers and sisters, okay? Yani, this is good for the videos. Maybe there is a new information in the video and you like it. You get a lot of benefit from this lecture. So mention this in the comment. It will not take a long time. It will take less than 1 minute. And inshallah, it will be useful for that sheikh, and also it will be useful for the people. Because people usually they check any comment, okay, under this video or not. So if there is comment, خلاص, you will encourage them to listen to the lecture. So please, brothers, sisters, okay, try to to write something. I will not say this is wajib, and also I'm not saying you have to mention this is a good lecture. Maybe you don't like the lecture, خلاص, don't mention. Don't mention. Okay, or mention if you want. Mention, this is not a good lecture, okay? طيب. I mean, this will be helpful for the da'wah. This will be helpful for the da'wah. Maybe you can mention, wallahi, I learned new information from this lecture that it is sunnah to say this and this after the salah. Or you can mention, wallahi, I learned that this hadith is not authentic. And you mention the hadith and you keep it in the comment. Okay? So, this will be helpful for the da'wah, inshallah. Jazakum Allah khair.